Welcome to this demo class on object-oriented programming. Myself, N. Karthikeyan, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE, Government College of Engineering, Sengipetithan Chowdhury. So in this video, I'm going to discuss the concept of abstract classes and methods. Before going to know about abstract classes, just I want to recall what is inheritance. So inheritance is the process of accessing the property of one classes into another class. So whenever, if you are creating any object for the particular class, the memory allocated for the instance, I mean each and every object, there is a separate memory will be allocated for every object, means every class, means object. So, but in some situation, I have only the part, means the class contains only the basic information of the class definition. The class need to be combined with some other classes to complete the one implementation of the entire process. So in this situation, only that the base class have a partial information, so that if you are creating an object, for the creation of the object for this classes is not exam, it's not a correct way for creating an object. In this video, I'm going to explain the concept of abstract classes and methods. So before going to talk about the abstract classes, just let us take one simple example. In an Anna University, so there are two examinations we have for a particular course for making the students to have a clear idea about that. One is the internal examination. So through this internal examination, the university to access the knowledge level of the every student, and also they are asking that how much percentage of students how much attendance percentage they are having. So from the data, so it having only the partial information about the student. Student for qualification criteria. So from that, that means that Anna University create a memory space for creating a hall ticket once this 75% of the attendance criteria is satisfied. So if the students is not able to create, not able to meet this criteria, then automatically the memory which is allocated for that attendance and marks will be deallocated, and the students once again rejoin in the next year and to work to do the same course, same semester once again. So in this, that entire implementation of the internal examination, only that half part of your class implementation. So then if you are allocating a memory only for this internal examination, it's not meaningful way. So always we need to combine this internal examination, the information, with the external information in order to make your application as exactly. So from that we can easily to understand that here we are not allowing to create an object for the internal examination. So we need to create an object for this external examination by using this, the details of the internal examinations also to be maintained. So see the linking. So here the internal examination will be acted as a base for this external examination, so that this internal examination acts as a base class to access the information. So like that, so once if you want to do implement, we can go with the concept of abstract classes. So here the abstract classes is always to act as a base class. So here you can make any classes abstract classes. So that's, I mean, that always the abstract class will be act as a base class. So that the general syntax for creating abstract classes, abstract, it is a keyword, then followed by the class, it is a keyword, then followed by this class name. It means that normal different, that means the definition of the class, before the normal definition of the class, just you can add a keyword that is called abstract. It means that it will not allow to create an instance of an object, and also it will be act as a base class. Okay, let us discuss with one example. Oh, class, I'm going to create a demo. So I'm going to create a one class to maintain, I mean, sir, I'm going to create for a single entry point. So take one command line arguments. So as usual, you know that whenever if you want to access any property of class, the object plays the major role. So just to create all, and I can save it at absd.java. So now just I'm going to compile. So Java C, so absd. So now just to compile, there is no issue. And here we must know, we must know about the properties of the class. So the property of the class means that it consists of data members, constructors, destructors, instructors and as well as Samantha. Okay, so just I will wait for compilations to complete, and so a little bit slow to terminate. Yeah, yes, so there is no error. So here I have empty class definitions. Actually, the empty class definition is no useful, but anyway, just for understanding purpose, just I created empty class definition. So according to the syntax or concept of abstract classes, I mean, if you are adding the keyword, the class will be as abstract. And that means that for abstract classes, if you are creating an instance, that is, instance means that it is an object, then it creates an error. Okay, so for this example, I didn't have any abstract classes. Now I'm going to convert the class as abstract class, so by adding the abstract keyword in front of the class definition. So now the class demo is called is a abstract classes. So always it will be act as a base class. So for this base class, we are unable to create an object. Okay, so now just I'm compile now. But in last run compilation, there is no error. But here there is an error will be created because demo is an abstract. So that we are unable to instantiate. That means that we are unable to create an instance. It means we are unable to create an object for abstract class. So because the abstract class is always to act as a base class. So if you want to define all this, but if this abstract class consists of a different all kind of definitions, for example, I have a go with the local women's constructors. Here I just defined it default constructor. Even we want, we can use parameterized constructor also. So that's on our choices. This dot a equal to a. So the constructor is implemented. So it's also I'm going to display the method to display the value of this variable. So system.out.println. So slash in. So the value of a equal to just trying to display the value of a. So now the class definition is over. But we know that it's a very means for example, just I'm going to remove this abstract now. So now the class definition is created with some content. So just I'm going to compile now. So that means that the class demo is not abstract classes. So that, yeah, system is a keyword. Just I made a small correction. Just I'm going to compile. So no error. Just I'm going to run it. So we know that just it will display the value of a equal to 10. Yeah, sorry, but here the properties of the class is not accessed, so that I'm going to access it. I'm going to run it so that the value of a is printed as a 10. But here I just define it as a normal class definition. So now I'm going to create it as abstract class. So just if I'm going to create it as abstract class, we know that abstract class is not allowed to create an object. So here the same error is will be displayed. Means that this is a error will be displayed even though the class is not having any method, means not having any means a content, that means not having any definition. But here the class consists of definition, but here the error will be shown only for a abstract keyword, not for the remaining definition. So from that we can understand that the abstract class contains the definition of the class, but it not allowed to create an object itself. So that's all. It will be act as a base class. So that if you want to access that, we have to use the concept of inheritance. So demo. But even though just I don't have any means a content inside of this derived class. But we know that by using a derived class, we are able to access all the properties. So instead of this demo, just I'm going to make it as a derived class. But by using this derived class property, we can able to, means by using this object of this derived class, we are able to access the property of base classes. Means that the abstract classes. It will not show any error messages. Only if you are creating abstract, means object for a base class, the compiler shown an error message. But here just I created an object for the derived class so that it doesn't make, means not showing, not doing any error message. Just I'm going to run it so we can do it. So from there we can clearly understand that by using the concept of abstract class, means by using the concept of derivative classes, we can able to access all the property of the derivative class, but we can't able to allocate a memory for abstract classes. So that if you are trying to create an object for an abstract classes, always it makes an error message. In C++, we call as a pure virtual function. So pure virtual functions always used to create an abstract classes. Okay. So now we know how to make an abstract classes, class as abstract. But here we are unable to create a class method like instance variable and as well as a constructor, destructor is not possible to make as abstract. But we can make the method as abstract. So we know how to create abstract classes. So by using the keyword abstract in front of class definition. Same way, if you want to create a method as abstract method, just you can create a keyword abstract in front of the function definition. But actually, if you want to define a method as abstract method, the base class must contain only contains the declaration, not the definition. For example, so this is abstract class. So I'm talking about method, but actually here it is a constructor. So that I told that not possible to create a constructor as abstract. Only we can able to make methods as abstract. So that now I just define it as abstract. So just I'm going to compile. But actually, if you are creating a function as abstract, so that means that the base class should not contain a definition. Means you can't use the definition inside of the base class. So the definition must be present only in a derived class. See that? So abstract void display. So that abstract method cannot have a body. It means that abstract method, the definition of the abstract method should not be present inside of the base class. It must have only the declaration per body. It means that the definition of the abstract method must be implemented only in derivative class. So that it means that we know that overriding. So that if always we know that it always we can take only the definition of the derivative classes. So that the definition inside of the base class is not at all visible. If you are going with the normal execution of method overriding. So that if you think like that, you can go with abstract method. So that if you are going to make a method as abstract method, the definition inside of your, that the definition is not allowed inside of your base class. It must have only the declaration part. We know what is the declaration part. So we have to define what is the first line of the function definition is always as a declaration part. So it must have a declaration only inside of class definition. So then after that you have to override it inside of the derived class. It means that the definition of the abstract method must be defined only inside of derived class. I will repeat once again. So the base class contains only the declaration and this method is overrided in derived classes and this method will be accessed by using derived class object. So I can show it once again. Just I'm going to run it. Our compilation is over, no error. Just I'm going to run it. It shows as usual the value of the A is accessed in derived classes. No error message will be displayed. But only the problem is, only the important thing is the abstract method is not having any definition. So not having any definition in base class. Must have only the definition must in only in derived class. Only the declaration must be here. The definition must be present only in derived classes only. So that the derived class definition, base class definition is overridden in derived class. Okay. So for example, if I assume that I don't have a abstract class, but I want to define the method as abstract method. Even n number of methods are allowed to define as abstract, but all the methods must be implemented inside of the derived class. For example, I can show it. Okay, before this, I can explain that if I'm not using a keyword abstract keyword in front of the class definition, but I think that I included one abstract method inside of my class definition. So in this case, we must define an abstract keyword in front of the class definition. Otherwise, the compiler throw an error message that the method is abstract, so that the moment you can't able to use the concept of overriding for non-abstract classes. See that demo is not an abstract classes, it is a non-abstract class, and we unable to do a overriding concept for the display method. Because so if I have a definition inside of the class, it means that if I have a definition inside of the class, for example, I have the definition like this without the keyword, this is a non-abstract method, it will be allowed. But here it is an abstract method. So this is the abstract method, so that the definition is not allowed inside of the base class. So that means the definition should be overridden only in the derived class. And the next thing is next very important thing what we need to consider, that once you are making create classes abstract classes, means if the class contains abstract method, surely the class also must be an abstract. Otherwise the compiler is not allowed to compile. So if you want to create any method as abstract classes, surely that means that that method, and the class also must be an abstract method. So no error, then I'm going to run it, it will work as usual. So we know that the properties of the class, everything will be accessed. Okay, in case I'm forgot to implement this method, display method, I'm forgot to override this definition inside of the derived class. Now check it out, is there any issue or not? Because we need to think about this way also. So if the abstract method is not implemented in derived class, what will happen? So if the abstract method not implemented in the derived class, then the derived class is also will be act as abstract class. I will repeat once again, if the definition of the abstract class, that means the method, that means abstract method is not defined in the derived class, then the derived class is also to act as abstract classes, so that the derived class, for derived class also be unable to create an object. So that it makes an error message that the derived class is not an abstract classes, so that it is not allowed to create object. So error will be displayed only on the 16th line. So just you can go and check it, what is the line 16th line. So this is a line, so it will be abstract, so that you have to use the keyword as abstract. So if you are creating the keyword, means the class is abstract class, so then see the error, what is the error? Surely there is an error, there is an error on object creation. So from that we can easy to clear to understand that if the class, that means the abstract method is not implemented in derived class, then the derived class is also will be act as a abstract class. So this is the thing we need to understand. So just the compilation over, now there is no error. So because that derived class means that the abstract method is implemented in derived class, so that it will be act as a non-static class. So for as a non-abstract class, so that non-abstract class we are able to create an object and access the properties. So it's a happened here. So just to finally I can summarize it about abstract classes. So we know that for abstract class is unable to create an object. If you are trying to create an object, it makes an error message. For abstract method, so the syntax is only the class can only the base class contains the declaration part, and the definition must be implemented only in a derived class only. So if the class contains the abstract method, surely the class means that the class also must be an abstract class. And another one important thing, so if that abstract method is not implemented, so method is not implemented in derived class, so implemented in derived class, the derived class is also an abstract class. This is the thing we need to clearly to understand. So this is the final recall of this topic. Abstract classes means it will be act as a only base class. Object creation is not allowed. And so for abstract method, so if the class consists of abstract method, surely the class means that abstract the class also must be an abstract. So that the method, the definition of the abstract must be defined inside. That means the definition of the abstract method must be present in base, means in derived class. Otherwise, the derived class is also to act as abstract class. Thank you.